Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is Survey Problems Part 5. We're going to create and use a Venn diagram to answer a survey problem where three sets are involved. So here's our problem. A survey about which of the three beverages, tea, coffee, milk, people drank daily revealed the following. Seven drank only coffee. So no coffee or, I mean, no tea or milk for that set of people, right? 21 drank coffee. One drank only tea and milk. Six drank all three. Four drank none of the three. 21 drank tea. 11 drank tea and coffee. Nine drank neither coffee nor tea. So let's answer a couple questions. How many people were surveyed and how many drank only milk? Hopefully, if you've been watching my videos, you know you can't just add those numbers up because there's some intersections going on, etc. So since we're talking about three different things, tea, coffee, and milk, let's do a Venn diagram with three sets. So we've got the universe. So we've got tea, coffee, and milk. How about I let this be the tea, this be the coffee, and this be the milk? Now, remember, tea, there's four regions here. Like over here, people only like tea, but here's the intersection of people that like both tea and coffee. And then up in this little tiny piece here, these are the people that like tea and coffee, but they didn't like milk, etc. So there's a lot going on here. So let's see if we can fill in. Seven drank only coffee. All right, so is that just one region here? Here's the coffee region, all four pieces, but where's the piece, the region where they only drank coffee? That would just be this part here. They're not part of the tea or milk. So I could fill that in, and I've just used that piece of information. Next, we've got the second clue. 21 drank coffee. Well, coffee is made up of four pieces, and I've only got one piece so far. So I'm not going to, I know that altogether these four numbers have to add up to 21. So I'm not sure what I'm going to put here. I know that these three numbers will add up to 14, right? Because then when I add it to 7, I'll get 21. But I can't get know any more than that quite yet. How about the next one? One drank only tea and milk. All right, so let's look at tea and milk. Here's the intersection of tea and milk, but this says only tea and milk. So that means not coffee, right? So if it says only tea and milk, I don't get it. They don't get to also drink coffee. So I can actually use that clue, and one is going to go just in that little region right there. Six drank all three. All right, so what does that mean if you drank all three beverages? That's the intersection of all three of these sets right in the center. Six goes right in the center. So I've used this clue. Four drank none of the three. All right, what does that mean if you're not in any of these sets? It means you're out here someplace, right? So there are four people that didn't drink any of those beverages on a daily basis. So I used that clue. 21 drank tea. Okay, so let's see. Here's my set of people that like tea. I've got two regions filled in, but there's two regions left to fill in, so I can't fill that in. I wouldn't know how to split it up so that all these add up to 21. In fact, if this is 7, there's going to be again, what's 7 plus 14, I think is going. So these two numbers have to add up to 14, but I don't know how to split it up. How about the people that drank tea and coffee? 11 drank tea and coffee. Okay, so we look at the intersection of tea and coffee, which is right here. There's two pieces, but one's filled in. So I know that together these have to add up to 11. So there's six here. Five has to be the piece that goes up here. So five and six add up to 11, and I've just used that clue. All right, the next one. Nine drank neither coffee nor tea. All right, what does that mean? They are not in this coffee circle, and they're not in the tea circle either, right? At all. So if we look at the coffee or T circle. We put them together. We've got all this, but notice there are two pieces outside there. The people that only liked milk and the people who didn't like anything. So be careful. A lot of people want to put 9 right here. That isn't going to work because now you've got 13 that didn't like coffee or tea. So be careful. That's not 9. Together, these two pieces have to add up to 9. So if this is 4, this then would have to be 5. And I've just used that clue. All right, I've gone through and used all the clues I can so far, so let's go back up and see if we could finish filling the rest of this out. I've got that 21 drank coffee, and notice I've filled in 3 of the 4 pieces so far. So I have 18. 5, 7, and 6 add up to 18, and there's 21 total. So what's left here for this little piece has got to be 3. Now that adds up to 21. So we've used that clue. Also, 21 drank tea. We're going to do the same thing. So we're looking at this set of people that like tea. We've got 1, 6, and 5 already accounted for. So 12 people are accounted for. So 12 plus what? 9 would add up to 21. And now I've filled in all 8 regions. So now, how are we going to answer the question? How many people were surveyed? So I would add all 8 numbers you see here. So let's see, I've got 10, 20, 30. Wait a minute. Is it 10, 20, 30? I think I've got 40. I see 40. I'm going to double check that, and you should too. 11, 14, 20. Yep, I got 40 again. How many drank only milk? All right, where's that going to be? Right in here. These 5 people drank milk. They don't get, you can't include these people who also drank coffee and or tea. So we've got 5. Now the last thing to do is go back to all, with through all your clues and make sure those numbers still match up correctly. All right, 7 drank only coffee. All right, so look over here. 7, where's the people that drank only coffee? Right here, I do have 7. Looks good. So I check that off. Yep, that worked. 21 drank coffee. So now I look at the circle with the coffee. Make sure that adds up to 21. And 5, 7, 6, and 9 do add up to 21. Okay, check that one. 1 drank only tea and milk. All right, so only tea and milk means they liked both tea and milk. So I have to look here, but it says only. I don't get to include the coffee people, so that's the 1. Good. 6 drank all 3. That's the intersection of all 3 drinks. That's in the center of 6. Looks good. 4 drank none of the 3. Well, that would be out here, and I've got 4, so that looks good. 21 drank tea. So you look in the set of people that drank tea and you add up these 4 numbers, and that does add up to 21. Looks good. 11 drank tea and coffee. So now we're going to look at the intersection of tea and coffee. So that's right here in the center. 5 and 6 add up to 11. Good. And 9 drank neither coffee nor tea. Okay, so that includes the people that only liked milk or didn't like any drink, and that is the 5 plus 4. So all is done. So our answer should be correct. If we go back up, let's check one more time. How many people were surveyed? You're going to add the 8 numbers. You should get 40. How many drank only milk? That's just these 5 people right here. And then you could, you know, I could ask a whole bunch of other questions as well. You could make up your own problems. These aren't so easy to make up. I'm not going to go over how I made them up, but you could try it on your own. See if you can give 8 clues. Usually the trick is that if you're going to have 8 regions, usually you're going to have to give 8 clues, and they have to be kind of careful. So you could fill in eventually, you know, at the beginning, there's at least going to be just one specific place you could fill in and work up through there. All right, so I'd suggest you take this exact same problem without the answer, without the Venn diagram, all on your own and try it and see if you could get the answer. And let's just ask one more question just for fun. How many did not drink milk? What would that be? I'm going to look at the milk circle and look outside of that, and I've got 9, 5, 7, and 4. So that is, let's see, 4 and 7 is 11, plus the 9 is 25. I got 25. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.